Hi, and welcome to this video explaining how to get started with the isolated AC switch evolution board.
You need three boards that are available on STMicroelectronics and major electronic distributor websites: the STEVAL JLA001V1, the XNucleo IHM09M1, the Nucleo F030R8. Make sure that SB16 and SB50 are closed. Place GP5 strap on the right on U5V position. Place SW200 strap on the bottom on 3.3 position and make sure that SW100 switch is on off position. Due to dangerous voltage on the board, it is strictly forbidden to make any connection between high voltage and isolated voltage. When the red LED is switched on, it means that a high voltage is present. Because of mains voltage presence, you have to be careful with all connections between the boards and all equipment used, particularly ground return. For your safety, please follow these recommendations. Use isolated gloves, even in the green section. Use an insulated transformer to supply the oscilloscope. Use differential voltage probes and use a PC working on battery. First, plug the Nucleo board to the XNucleo board. Then connect STEVAL board to XNucleo board with the provided ribbon cable. Connect a PC to the Nucleo with the mini USB cable. Then connect AC voltage on J100 and the load directly to the load connectors, J101 to J103. Visit st.com and search for the keyword STEVAL JLA001V1. Click on the main part number link. Go to the Tools and Software section and click on STSW JLA001V1 part number link. Go to the end of the page and click on Get Software button in the Get Software section. After connecting the Nucleo to the PC, the board is automatically detected and seen as a disk drive. Drag and drop the binary file onto the Nucleo disk drive. The Nucleo firmware embeds a user interface which enables you to have access to many parameters easily. You can use software such as HyperTerminal or TeraTerm. First, select the serial port corresponding to the Nucleo, generally the only one available, and configure the port as shown. Press the black button on the Nucleo. A menu appears. This menu contains all available commands to configure and use our Triax. Use a high voltage differential probe and connect the positive terminal to the neutral test point and the negative terminal to the line test point of STEVAL board. Use a second differential probe and connect the positive terminal to PC4 of the Nucleo board and the negative terminal to the GND test point of the STEVAL board. Turn on the STEVAL board by switching on SW100. Measure the time between the mains voltage zero crossing and the pulse generated by the Nucleo board. On the user interface, if the menu doesn't appear, type list. Type set TDZVS and enter the value measured previously in microseconds. This operation is only done once at the first startup. Type store data and switch off the STEVAL board. Taking the first high voltage differential probe, connect the positive terminal to the out test point of the selected triac and the negative terminal to the VCC AC test point. Use a second differential probe and connect the positive terminal to the G test point of the selected triac and the negative terminal to the GND test point. Use a current probe and check that the current is going in the right direction. Turn on the STEVAL board by switching on SW100.
Now we have finished our setup and everything is working okay. So let's start our demonstration of the three different modes that are available in the Nucleo firmware. This corresponds to the three different ways to control the triac gate and consequently the load.
In on-off basic mode, the triac is switched on after pressing the triac button and then switched off after pressing one more time. The trial gate can be controlled by pulse or continuous command. Pulse command is less energy consuming but needs an accurate gate synchronization. Set SW201 mode switch to top position. On the board, you can use the triac buttons to switch on and off the load, and TP plus and TP minus buttons to modify the pulse width. On the user interface, there are commands available to start and stop the load. Here you can see and modify all parameters that can be used in on-off basic mode. In on-off timer mode, the triac is switched on after pressing the triac button and then switched off after a defined duration. As with the on-off basic mode, the triac gate can be controlled by pulse or continuous command. Set SW201 mode switch to bottom position. On the board, you can use the triac buttons to switch on the load, TP plus and TP minus buttons to modify the pulse width, and time plus and time minus buttons to modify the timer duration. On the user interface, there are commands available to start and stop the load. Here you can see and modify all parameters that can be used in on-off timer mode. In the phase control mode, the triac is switched on after pressing the triac button and then switched off after pressing one more time. The triac gate is controlled at the end of the half period with a modifiable pulse width. This enables the user to modify RMS current and consequently load power, for example, dimming a lamp. Set SW201 mode switch to the middle position. On the board, you can use the triac buttons to switch on and off the load, and power plus and power minus buttons to modify the pulse width and consequently load power. On the user interface, there are commands available to start and stop the load. Here you can see and modify all parameters that can be used in fast control mode. All details about the operating modes, the user interface, and all useful information are available in the board and firmware user manuals. You can find them on the STVL JLA001V1 and the STSW-JLA001V1 website. Thanks for watching this video. For more information about SAR and TRIAC solutions, visit st.com/servicestores.